Howdy, fellas. How's it going? You'll notice I'm in a different car today. And that is because my Chrysler is currently in Firestone. I'm putting new tires on. I got new Pirelli P4s. It's awesome. They're so good. But man, they're pricey. Well, you know, not the most expensive tires ever, but definitely more expensive than like them $30 Kumho or Hankook or Toyo or whatever fucking Chinese, Japanese tires. See, I like Michelins, I like Dunlops, and I like Pirellis. And those happen to be somewhat, slightly pricier. I just like the ride quality, you know, and the tread wear, and so on and so forth. Anyways, these Pirelli P4s. So, the old ones that I had on the Chrysler, two in the front are, like, bald. And the two in the back are, like, dry rotted. These tires are almost 10 years old, okay, because they have a printed date on the side. The DOT number and whatever. Look at this asshole. What? Oh. Anyways, I'm sorry that I can't show you the new tires right away. I'll show them after the video, towards the end of the video when I get my car back. But you know, it's because I woke up in the morning and I didn't even have coffee. Like right now, I don't even have enough coffee. But you know, I woke up and I went to the Firestone and I was like, I have four tires. Can you put new valve stems, mount, balance, alignment, and they're like, does your car have TPMS or not? And I was just like, $89? So it was pretty funny, but I love Firestone. Firestone is awesome for little nitpicky things, because I normally hate chain mechanics. That's a video for another time, but Firestone is an exception. I love Firestone. I kind of just treat them as like a NASCAR pit stop or something, you know, but that's kind of unfortunate because they have brilliant mechanics working there. All of my experiences at Firestone have been very positive, right? And these guys somewhat know me. They know that I'm, you know, not a frequent customer, but a customer. So they're like, hey, how's it going? Welcome back. Yeah, we'll mount those tires for you, etc., etc. So the tires themselves, I believe, four of them. There were four of them for like $128 each, right? And then there was like $38.89 shipping. And then on top of that, there was also sales tax or whatever. So the total bill came out to be like something like $438 or so. But Pirelli is currently doing a rebate, mail-in rebate kind of type of deal. So I'm going to fill out a form and I'm going to send it in. Hopefully I get $60 back as a Visa gift card or whatever the fuck. And the tires themselves have a 90,000 mile tread wear warranty, which is pretty good for tires. Normal tread wear warranties, they go from like 40,000, 50,000, and then I've seen some that are like 60 and 80,000, you know, so 90,000, that's pretty cool. And I know this is true because the current tires that I have on are like 10 years old, and they probably did like 120,000 miles on it. And the only reason I'm switching them out is because I didn't rotate them like a dumbass. See, because I looked at the tires and I saw that there was some like a dry rot going on, and I was like, you know, it's time to change them, so I'm not going to bother rotating them. And because I didn't rotate them, I basically hurried up the process at which I have to suddenly fucking buy tires, if that makes sense. I mean, on one hand, it's good that I did that. I forced myself to buy new tires. On the other hand, damn, those tires still could have gone. I'll show you the old ones when I get them back. I told them to keep the old tires. I know I'm just off the wall crazy, like fucking jumping from topic to topic here, but I'm just stoked, man. Fresh new Pirelli P4s. I got Pirelli P4s again because I really liked those tires. And they should last me pretty much till the end of the car's life. Firestone has a alignment special going on, so lifetime alignment for basically $150. Means I never have to pay another fucking alignment for the rest of the life of the car. Means I get alignments whenever, however, etc., etc. Tires, freshly mounted, balanced, new valve stems. But yeah, tires. So that's a lot of good old fun. And I can't wait. Currently, right now, I'm just waiting to get my car back. So I got time to kill. So yeah, I went on Amazon.com. These Pirellis were actually very hard to find. So yeah, these Pirellis were actually very hard to find. Walmart only had one of them. Sears didn't have them. Mavis only had one of them. What else did I check? Pep Boys, their prices were fucking outrageous and they didn't have one in my size. Amazon had them, but they were expensive. Fortunately, I found a seller on Amazon and I got them for like $128 each. It was called TiresEasy.com and they came in from California, I think. Pretty good. They came within like 1 or 2 days, like, damn. So I'm glad I actually didn't buy them from Amazon for once. Very fast shipping. Tires in excellent condition. And yeah, since I didn't have my coffee in the morning, I got the wrong... I left my sunglasses in the car. So now I'm wearing these gold weird sunglasses and I feel awkward as hell. Yep. So today I'm just going to chill out and wait for my tires, and when the tires are, I'll show you the new ones and the old ones. But yeah, that's the general story. That's all the warranties. Oh, and the Tires Easy also gave me like some roadside hazard insurance included or whatever for the price of the tires. So for like 30,000 miles or something, if something happens, they give me $300 or something for new tires or whatever. Yeah, so the 90,000 mile treadwear warranty, free alignments for the rest of my life. New valve stems, mounted, balanced, installed, blah, 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 blah. I'm just so excited, I'm just rambling on and on and on and on. But today's just a chill out day until I get my car back, because I went in there and I was just like, yeah, guys, just do it whenever. So whether I get it back in 30 minutes or at 6 p.m. or whatever, I don't know yet, because I told them to do it on their own schedule. So while we wait, we're going to play my favorite game from my childhood. This is called Road Rashers, made in 1996. Do that every time. Oops, my bad. Oops. Oh, fuck. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. There we go. No! I got on the bike! I played for what? 5 minutes? Is this really what Napa Valley looks like? Napa? If you're watching this. Crap. Fuck you. On the left, always. How are you even? Look at this. He's dead set on like trying to get me back. Look at this crap. Excuse me. Haha. Oh no, there's a tree. Fuck. Nice. There we go. Revenge is sweet. I can't even. So by pure coincidence, my friend from Pennsylvania had to go to the mechanic for whatever reason as well, so we just went and we picked up his car. Firestone still hadn't called me yet. That's what I get for walking in there and saying just get it done whenever possible, I guess. So for now, I'm just chilling out with my friend. He's right in front of me. And yeah, we're just chilling. So yeah, these Pirelli P4s, I think they're discontinued. I mean, the Pirelli P4s themselves are not discontinued, but the size was. The size was P215/65R1799T. So yeah, that size appeared to be discontinued. These new tires, they were manufactured in like the 19th week of 2015. So they're only 2 years old, which is much better than my... See, since he's my friend, I can hog the shit out of him, right? First off, why are we both in soccer mom cars? That's quite ridiculous. So the importance of shopping around for these tires is tremendous. Walmart only had one of them. Mavis only had one of them. Pep Boys, they had them for an outrageous price. Amazon was selling them for like $138.42 each, I believe. And they only had six in stock when I checked. And on the drop-down list for other sellers or whatever, I saw that they also had Walmart listed under there, among other things. And under this place called TiresEasy.com. And they had them for like $128 or so each. Okay. Shipping was like $40. Yeah, I talked about this already, but the point is they shipped so fast and I was so surprised. Really pleasantly surprised. So yeah, since these tires that I have are 10 years old and two are bald and two are dry rotted, I'm gonna be using new tires. Fuck. See, that was the auto braking thing. Usually I turn that shit off. That's one feature that I really hate about this car, because there'll be a cyclist on the right side, for example, and then the cyclist comes like around the left, like he just goes in front of your car, and you know you won't hit him, but he cuts in so close that the car interprets that as a threat and just slams on the brakes. And then fucking you end up brake checking someone for no reason. Dangerous. What's the rush, asshole? Oh! Do you want a GoPro?
The mechanic left his screwdriver.
The mechanic left his screwdriver?
Who are you talking to?
My GoPro! Oh. Who else? New thumbnail, show him the screwdriver. Told you he's my friend.
Not his friend.
You are!
You're a random person that's following me with a camera.
How about we race our fucking soccer mom cars? No, don't rev, you just got back from a $500 service. What are you doing? Up, oh, zipper merge! Haha, you're ready last! What a madman. Alright. Sayonara! I'm gonna cut him off. Whatever you do, don't throw that screwdriver in here. Don't! Friend is still in last place! I'm putting on distance. Motherfucker, you're on a camera. On a camera. Look at that, I still got him blocked. I'm like, oh, fucking whatever right now. Just to fucking piss him off. Firestone called. Oh yeah. They got my car all set and ready to go. It was just pretty funny because this is around the same time my friend fucking picked up his car. So he just screws around, maybe we'll go stop by the Firestone. I wish I had the foresight to record the telephone call. But essentially what went down was I decided... The tire disposal fee or whatever was $3, right? And for some reason I thought it would be like $30 or something. So I just told them to get rid of the tires. So I won't be able to show you what the old tires look like. I mean, I have photos. So I'll be able to put up some photos, but they won't be on video side-by-side comparisons. I'm very sorry about that. Let's see, what else? So yeah, I'm currently in Firestone bound. I told them I'd be there within 30 minutes to an hour. Funny conversation, we were all laughing and stuff because I was just driving. But yeah, so I'm gonna go pick up my car, gonna ditch those old tires, cost $3. I don't know why I thought it would cost $30, but oh, that's a huge pothole. Okay. Yeah, so, oh, that guy behind us went right into it. Yeah. The speed demon time, go over, go home, get the car, inspect the job. Inspect the new tires. And stop! Woo! Yeehaw! New tires! Gotta go get them! Yeah, where's my friend? I feel like I ditched him way back. Now we're playing a real life game of cops and robbers. We got separated. Apparently he's on Fort Hamilton Avenue. So let's see if I can find him and intercept him, I guess? Where am I gonna find this bastard? How did he get on Fort Hamilton? How is that even possible? This way. How are you even on Fort Hamilton? Fuck, dude! Got him! Woo! Pull over, asshole! What? Snap, new Pirellios! Pirelli P4s. Got the car back. Currently I'm doing a test drive right now and everything is tip top. Alright. So just a general breakdown of what happened here. I went to Firestone and I brought my own tires and I asked them to put in new valve stems, mount them, balance them, install them, and since the lifetime alignment was on special, normally it's almost like $200 I think for a lifetime alignment, they had it on sale for like $149.99 or something like that. I also got a lifetime alignment as well. Everything is tip top and oh my god, these new tires are so good, they're so fresh, I love them. The new tires are just fantastic. The reason I got Pirelli P4s again. See, I think the title of this video is going to be I Get New Tires, and the thumbnail might be just my car with the tires blacked out or whatever, but I got the same tires, but I just love them. So, these tires will probably live to the end of the car, and I could probably take them off and sell them too. So, yeah. Now, here's how it went down with the Firestone. I went in there and I asked for, you know, the services, and the bill came out to be $260 basically for the alignment, for the discounted lifetime alignment and the mounting and all that stuff. But they have a different price for regular and for tires with like TPMS or whatever. So I went in there and they asked me if I was keeping the tires and I said yes. My original plan was to try and sell these tires on Craigslist for like, I don't know, let it even be $20 just for drift tires so that I can earn some money back for the new tires that I spent money on. For some reason, I thought the tire disposal fee was going to be like $30 as well. So as they were working on my car, I thought about it and I was like, you know what? the tires actually barely fit in my car. It's gonna be a real pain in the ass to put in my car and haul around each time somebody on Craigslist would want to buy my tires or whatever the hell. And maybe like they flake out or whatever. That's gonna be a lot of trips of time. I just decided not to bother with it over like $50 or whatever. So I called. So they called me and they said, you know, we got your car ready. And I said, the tire recycling fee is actually $3 for all four tires. You guys can just ditch the tires. And they're like, okay, yeah, you know, when you get here, we'll figure out the details. I said, okay. So they said, we'll figure out the details. So I got there and, you know, I opened the car and I see that all the four tires are in there. And I felt so bad because these tires, they made them look really good. Like, they cleaned them up so good that they looked so much better than they were mounted on when they were mounted on the car. So I was like, I feel so bad for the technician that actually fucking pulled off the tires and, like, I don't know, scrubbed them with a brush or something, made them look freaking good. So I felt so bad, but I, you know, I paid them the $3 and I took the tires out of my car and I just gave it back to them. If they recycle it or if they resell it, that's on them now. I don't have to bother with that. That was that. And then I also went to the clerk and I was like, you know, I read over the invoice and I saw that, you know, I was charged the price for TPMS. So I know I signed the bill fair and square for $260, but do you think we could somehow double check to make sure that it has or doesn't have TPMS? And the clerk was like, yeah, not a problem at all, dude. And I was like, oh, okay, awesome. So he asked me if it has a TPMS light. And I said, it does have a TPMS light, but when the tire pressure runs low, it doesn't warn me. So I guess it's just the same instrument cluster that they put into every Chrysler 300, but some have TPMS, some don't. Just to be sure, can we ask the technician? And he said, yeah, I'll go ask him right now. He asked the technician. Technician said, no, there's no TPMS. So that brought my bill total down from $261 or $260 down to $229.80 or whatever that was. Basically $230. So for $230, I got all four tires mounted, new valve stems, balance, and I have a lifetime alignment. Very good. And they did a very good job. Everything's aligned. Like, I'm test driving this right now. Obviously, I'm running into every single fucking pothole I can find for some reason, but I like it. I love Firestone. I normally try to avoid mechanics or whatever, but as far as like little NASCAR tire pit stop thingies go and whatever, Firestone is awesome. I just drop my car off on a day that I don't need it, and I say, hey fellas, just finish this at some point today. And they're like, yeah, no problem. And the price isn't too bad, you know. You just have to make sure you talk to them and figure things out a little bit and so on. I'm incredibly satisfied. I'm so happy that I have new tires. Everything is tip top. I'm just on the test drive now. Yeah, so I'm sorry if I was like stammering a lot in this video. Today was more of like a chill out with me / look at what's new with my life kind of type of video, I guess. So if I just ramble on and I'm not too coherent, I'm sorry about that. You just ran a red light. Okay? Yeah. So as I was saying, if I was stammering around a lot, if I don't make too much sense, I'm very sorry about that, guys. Today was just a chill out type of video. Let viewers chill out with me, I guess you could pretend. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you so much for watching. If you're new here, please subscribe. Let me know in the comments what you think. And have a good one. Meanwhile, I'll drive around on my brand new Pirellios. Oh, and just as an aside over here, just for a second, I just wanted to take a minute to congratulate my friends. In recent news, well, by the time this video gets published, it'll be recent olds, I guess. But in recent news, Jacob Hardy, the guy with the red beat up VW that has like 300 plus thousand miles, he recently got himself a spanking new car. I mean, it's not fresh from the dealership, but it's a very clean Subaru STI. That's fucking ridiculous. I'm not gonna fuck with Jacob's car. Fuck that.
Telling.
Yeah.
System detected improper connection of parking brake lead. Please check your configuration for safety. Please see operation map.
Nope, we don't need that.
Yeah,
race car. Fuck safety. Race car, fuck safety.
And we went for a drive. Not too long ago, and it's a fantastic car, so congratulations, Jacob Hardy, for the new car. This cost him, I think, like 17 or 18 grand, and he had to go get it from Connecticut or something. And, you know, knowing Jacob Hardy, when he said he was going to get, his dream car was a Subaru STI, and then when he said he was going to go get one, we didn't doubt that he was going to go get one, but we just doubted, I guess, how fast he was going to get one. Does that make sense? Because he's like, oh, my parents owe me this much money, oh, you know, I got this much in the stock market, oh, you know, yeah, this much. And we're just like, yeah, like, suddenly you're gonna get 18 grand and buy, like, suddenly you're gonna get like 30 grand and buy a car, right? No, guess what, one of these days he just woke up, went to Connecticut, got himself a Subaru STI. So big congratulations to Jacob Hardy for his new car. And also big congratulations to Jacob Hardy. His YouTube channel just exploded, okay? He and another friend of mine, Static Stalfer, they got a chance to meet Street Speed 717. Street Speed 717 is a bit of a big figure here because, you know, he's not an extremely popular YouTuber, but he's a local guy, and his YouTube channel is pretty big. So Jacob Hardy is like all like crazy fangirl about Street Speed 717, and he actually got to meet Street Speed 717 and actually got to be in a reaction video with Street Speed 717. So he got a new car. Jacob Hardy got a new car. Jacob Hardy met his like favorite celebrity, okay? And on top of that, Jacob Hardy basically scored himself a shout out, and that made his YouTube channel explode from some 75 subs to, last I checked, 1,221. Not bad. So this month has just been really big for Jacob Hardy. Big congratulations for Jacob Hardy. Yeah, and also big congratulations for Static Stalfer. He also got to be in Street Speed 717's video and also got to meet Street Speed 717. And, you know, this was a very good day for them. So congratulations! As for me, I don't know what happened. I think I was busy that week or something. But it's actually quite funny because Jacob Hardy had less subscribers than I had. And now my channel is like dwarfed by his subscriber base. And not only that, But I think some of his subscribers have been leaking over into my channel, I guess, because my channel jumped from like 190 subscribers or so up to like almost 200, and it's still going up. So also pretty nice for me, even though I had nothing to do with it. So once again, very big congratulations to my friends Jacob Hardy and Static Stalfer. I'll put their channels in the end screen on this video. And yeah, thank you so much for watching.